Welcome students, myself Kukreja Rahul, and today we have to learn about the standard 9 mathematics. Okay, so in the previous session in the maths we have already seen the question 1, 2 and 3 from the exercise 7.2. okay, now we are go ahead from the question number 4. Okay, so let's start without wasting our time. So standard 9 and name of the chapter, that is triangle, we are learning. Okay, so now question number 4 from 7.2. okay, from exercise 7.2, question number 4. So in triangle ABC, which altitude BE and CF of two side AC and BE are equal, show that. Okay, here is the given, is also figure is given. Two things we have to prove. Okay, so for the that, first of all we have to draw figure. Okay, ABC is a triangle in which BE and CF, two side AC and BC, AC and AB are equal. BE, okay, we know that what is the mean of the altitude. Mean of altitude, that means right angle. And CF, okay, here the two altitudes are given. Okay, so in the given, BE is equal to CF. Altitudes are also given in triangle that are equal. To prove, we need to prove that triangle ABE congruent to triangle ACF. Triangle ABE congruent to triangle ACF. And second thing, that is AB equal to AC. AB is equal to the AC. Okay, we need to prove these two things. Okay, so let's start. In triangle ABE and ACF, first of all we have to draw these two triangles ABE, that is this triangle, and ACF, this triangle. ABE and ACF. Okay, ABE and ACF. Here both of this angle are 90 degree, in that, and BE is equal to CF are also given. Okay, and one of them we are taking also angle between them. Okay, angle between them A are common, so that therefore we are taking angle side congruency rule. In this also we are taking angle side congruency rule to prove that ABE is congruent to ACF. Okay, and by the CPCT rule, by the corresponding part of the congruent triangle, if these two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding part AB and AC are also must to be equal. Okay, so let's start to write. In that, first of all, BE is equal to CF, that is given. Second thing, that is angle AEB is equal to the angle AFC. Both of them are 90 degree and one of them angle BAE is equal to the angle CAF. Both of them are common. Both of them angle A, BAE and CAF, both of them angle A are common. Now, therefore, by angle-angle side congruency rule, triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACF. Okay, so therefore by CPCT rule, AB, corresponding part of the triangle, that is AB, is equal to the second part of the corresponding triangle, that is AC, are equal. Okay, so that's why we are writing that Hence rule. Clear? Please note down this. Clear? Now we are moving for the next question, question number 5. Dear students, please, if you have any doubt or any question, please notify me, okay? Because of this chapter is very, very important for the standard 10th, because based on this chapter, okay, in standard 10, you already, you also learn about the similarity of triangles, okay, that are depend on the congruency of the triangle, okay. So please keep in mind that you have to clear all these things in the triangle, okay. You should to clear all these things. So question number 5, that is ABC and DBC are two isosceles triangle on the base, on the same base BC. Show that ABD is equal to the ACD. Okay, here figure is like this. Okay, two triangles with the same base BC. Okay, first triangle is ABC and second triangle is BCD. Okay, and both of the triangles are isosceles triangle, so AB is equal to the AC and BD is equal to the CD. Okay, you should to prove given that is AB is equal to the AC and BD is equal to the CD. To prove, we need to prove the angles. This whole angle and this whole angle. ABD, angle ABD is equal to the angle ACD. We need to prove ABD is equal to the ACD. Okay. Now, this question are done with the two types. If you want to do this sum as a congruency rule, then you can go ahead for that. Okay. And if you want to do this sum as a isosceles triangle, as a rule of isosceles triangle, then you can also prove that as a isosceles theorem. Okay. So this sum are proven by the two types. Okay. So any one of them you can do it. Okay. Give you the solution of this question as the by the theorem of the criteria of the theorem of the triangles. Okay. So first of all, we have to draw the AD. Okay. First of all, we are moving for the congruency. Okay. So in the proof, first of all, we have to construct AD to form triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Okay. Now these two triangles are formed. One of them is ABD triangle and second one is ACD triangle. Okay. These two triangles. Now see this triangle and this triangle. Okay. So first of all, in the triangle ABD, ABD and second one triangle is ACD. So now in ABD and ACD, AB is equal to the AC. Okay, first thing. Second thing is BD is equal to the CD are also given in. Now AD in both of them, AD are common in both of the triangle. Okay, so that's why we are taking by SSS congruency rule to prove that both of the triangles are congruent. Okay, then by CPCT rule, corresponding part of the triangle is ABD is congruent to ACD. Okay, ABD are congruent or equal to the ACD, this angle. Okay, so in triangle ABD and ACD, in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, there is a AB. Now I'll write at the here. Therefore AB is equal to the AC, that is given. Second thing, that is BD is equal to the CD, that are also given. And third one is AD is equal to the AD, that are common in both of the triangle. Okay, so therefore by SSS congruency rule, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Okay, therefore by CPCT rule, the corresponding part, that is ABD and ACD, are equal. ABD is equal to the ACD. Hence prove. Clear? Please note down this first. Done. Okay. Now we are moving for the next question, that is question number 6. That are given that ABC is an isosceles triangle in which AB is equal to AC, side of BA produced to D such that AD is equal to AB. Okay, show that BCD is a right angle. So first of all we have to draw figure that are given. Okay, BCD, and here is my triangle, that is ABC. In the triangle ABC, that is AB is equal to AC, but they are drawn that AB is equal to AD, okay, because of the producing D, okay, AB is equal to AD. So show that. So first of all we are writing given, that is AB is equal to AC and AB is equal to AD, therefore AC is equal to AB is equal to AD. All of these three sides are equal. Okay. Now to prove, we need to prove angle BCD is a right angle. Okay. Clear? Now in the proof. So first of all, we know that theorem of the isosceles triangle, that is if sides are equal then opposite angles are also equal, their opposite angles are also equal. So therefore I'll write that angles opposite to the equal side are equal, so therefore therefore AB is equal to the AC is equal to the AD, then which angle are equal to each other, that is angle 1 is equal to the angle 2 because the opposite sides are equal. And in this triangle, these two angles, opposite angles are also equal because of these two sides are equal. So therefore angle 3 is equal to the also angle 4. Now we have to move for the angle sum property of the triangle. In triangle SBCD, इन ट्राइंगल बी सी डी यूजिंग एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी एंगल डी बी सी प्लस एंगल बी सी डी प्लस एंगल सी डी बी और बी डी सी एनी वन ऑफ देम यू कैन राइट इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री ओके देयरफॉर नाउ DBC, that means angle 1, plus angle BCD, that means angle 2 plus 4, okay, and angle BDC, angle BDC, that is means angle 3, is equal to 180 degree, therefore, now 1 and 2 are equal, so I'll write that is angle 2 plus angle 2 and 3 and 4 also are equal so I'll write angle 4 plus angle 4 okay I'll give this one as a equation and here we are writing that from equation 1 okay clear From equation 1, we are putting values of angle 1 as a angle 2, 2 is as it is, 4 as it is, and putting value of 3 as a angle 4. Okay, so therefore 2 time angle 2 plus 2 time angle 4 is equal to 180. Okay, clear? So therefore take 2 common angle 2 plus angle 4 is equal to 180. Now 2 shifted to second side so angle 2 plus angle 4 equal to 180 by 2 that are 90 degree so therefore angle 2 plus angle 4 equal to 90 degree so my angle 2 and 4 are combination of angle BCD therefore I'll write the angle BCD is equal to 90 degree hence proved Okay, clear? Note down this first. Please note down fast. Clear? Okay. Now question number 7. Previous question is question number 6. Now we are moving for question number 7. That is, the ABC is a right angle triangle in which angle A is 90 degree and AB is equal to the AC. ABC is a right angle triangle. In which angle A is 90 degree so I'll write A at here B and C is at here okay and second thing that is AB is equal to the AC that is given AB and AC both of the sides are equal and find angle B and C so first of all that is given triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. To find here they tell about that we need to find, okay, so therefore I'll write to find, okay, find angle B and angle C, these two angles, okay. So in the proof, sorry, not a proof, we are writing that solution, okay. Here's the solution, that is ABC is a right angle triangle and AB is equal to the AC. AB and AC are also given as equal. So AB is equal to the AC. Okay. Now in triangle ABC, angle A is equal to 90 degree and AB is equal to the AC. Therefore, angles opposite to the equal side are equal, so therefore AB and AC are equal, so their opposite angle C and angle B are also equal, therefore angle B is equal to the angle C. Okay, now using the angle sum property, now in triangle ABC, angle CAB plus angle ABC plus angle BCA is equal to 180 degree using angle sum property. Okay, so therefore first of all CAB, that is angle A, 90 degree given. Angle ABC, that is angle B, okay, plus angle BCA, that is angle C, is equal to 180 degree, therefore 90 shifted to second side, so angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 minus 90, therefore angle B plus angle C is equal to 90 degree. Now in this sum we have seen that B and C both of the angle are equal, so I'll write here angle B plus angle B is equal to 90 degree. I'll replace angle C as angle B, so therefore 2 times angle B is equal to 90 degree, therefore angle B is equal to 90 by 2, that is 45 degree. 90 by 2, 45 degree. Here is the angle B is 45 degree, therefore angle C is also equal to the 45 degree because of the both of the angle are equal. Okay, clear? Here we need not to write hence prove because we need to find. Okay, we don't need to prove. First of all, note down this, okay. Clear? So students, if you are enjoying this class, please notify me, okay. So till then we are done in question number 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, so last question of this exercise 7.2, we are moving for the next session. Okay, and we are seeing that question in the next session. Okay, so I hope you have to enjoy this class, and if you have any doubt or any question, please notify me. Okay, so till then, goodbye and stay blessed.